Hello my friends, welcome again to my video channel. Today we have part 3 of the videos about the Simpson 7M. I've promised you that I only have two parts. At the end of part 2 I said I will only make some basic tests and then the project is finalized, but I don't do a video about it. During my final tests I ran into a problem, small problem, not very big one, but I wanted to show it to you and how it can be solved. In the first video we have seen that this Simpson 260 was covered with a lot of labels on it, old labels, and on one of the labels there was written 9.7 indication is 10 amp. I thought, okay, not important, when I will align this or realign this multimeter then it's okay. But it wasn't. In the 10 amp range, the highest range, 10 amp DC range, I had a problem that full scale of 10 amp is approximately 9.7, in my case it was 9.6 amp or so, 9.7, 9.6, 9.7. This was an error, or is an error, of 3% and therefore out of specification. The specification specifies for all DC amp ranges 2%. Here we have 3%, okay. You can say, so what? But on the other hand, I was curious about the reason. What is the reason? I studied the schematic and I found that there was a shunt resistor in it, and the shunt resistor for the 10 amp range causes a certain voltage drop, and this voltage drop is measured, but this shunt resistor cannot be aligned or adjusted, so it is fixed. And if there is an error in the shunt resistor or something is not okay, then we have a problem in the indication. And again, this cannot be compensated. If the instrument is set properly, we still have an error here in my case. How does the 10 amp measurement work? We have two connectors, plus 10 amp, minus 10 amp. This is a shunt resistor, it's a long wire. We can see it here. Part of it, here it starts. Here we can see the wire. And on the other side, the wire comes back to the... it is the minus one, the minus pole here, this part. And this wire has a specific resistance. The length is L. And in my case, we have here at 9.7 amp a certain voltage drop, which is indicated. The relation is rather simple. It's a proportional relation. I can say the actual length L times 9.7 amp causes a voltage drop. But I want this voltage drop not at 9.7 amp. I want it at 10 amp. And I'm looking for the length LX. It's obvious that I have to shift it to a little bit lower resistance, lower shunt resistance. This is not a voltage here. Amps times length is ampere meter. I would have to use a constant conversion factor to make it into a voltage. It would be the diameter and the specific resistance, of course, of this wire, but this factor would be the same on both sides. So I delete this factor here and I only say 9.7 amp times L is 10 amp times LX. I'm looking for LX. It's 9.7 by 10 amps. It's length times length L. So LX is approximately 0.97 times L. Minus 3%. It means I have to reduce the length, the whole length L, by minus 3% to come to LX. This would be minus 3%, that's the error of a 3% we have. Specification again asks for plus minus 2%. And how to shift it? It's rather easy. How to compensate this error? Well, we have here the plus 10 amp connector. This is the beginning of the shunt. And here we have the tap piece of wire. First, this we can see it a little bit better. Okay, was connected here. Let me take here. It was connected here. And I shifted it into this direction. By try and error, I used a current, DC current of 10 amp flowing here through this meter. And then I've chosen the tapping, so I had a full scale deflection of exactly 10 amp and not 9.7 amp. It's rather easy. Simply shift it like a wiper of a pot and look for the right setting and then resolder it. That's all. I've done it and now it's okay. You may ask how to generate 10 amps. Well, I have a little bit of bigger power supply, two outputs up to 6 amps each, 0 to 6 amp, can be set separately. They can be connected in parallel, it's a linear power supply, so no problems. We have to be a little bit careful. The output voltage has to be set to approximately 2 volts or so. We don't need voltage, we only need current. Now we can connect them in parallel. That's not difficult. Minus to minus and plus to plus. Then the voltage is equal on both sides and then we can increase the current. But okay, I have forgotten to make a short circuit. No current flowing. Why is there no current? No connection. Plus. The connect minus here. Now we have voltage is zero and the current is limited. And then I can increase the current setting. 3 amps. No, the 3 amps. Slowly, slowly. Then we go to 4.9. That's a coarse and a fine setting. 5 amps. Also 5 amps. So we have here totally 10 amps. It's not getting warm, it's okay. It's a rather thick test lead here. Don't use these scrappy test leads from China. You need some diameter for 10 amps. Now we have here totally 10 amp flowing. We can measure it with a digital multimeter or so and calibrate the Simpson ohmmeter, voltmeter, volt ohmmeter. If you don't have 10 amp, it's not so difficult. You can also use, let me say, 2.5 amps each, so you go up to 5 amp totally. This would be also a solution. So we have totally 5 amp. The linearity of the movement is very good, so we can check it and align it also with 5 amps. I have forgotten to mention that this power supply has a rather intelligent circuit in it for very low output voltages and high currents. The secondary side of the output transformer of the AC side of the power transformer is reduced. There's a tapping and for low voltages, like here, there's a lower output voltage used to reduce the heat dissipation in the transistors, in the set of transistors of the power transistors to reduce the heat dissipation. Otherwise we would have a voltage drop of 30 volts times 6 amps. That's 180 watts. That's not so nice. You can hear it when I increase the voltage. Click clack, click clack. Hope you can hear it. The internal relay which is clicking and increasing the secondary side voltage, the input of the rectifier. Here is the final test setup. The multimeter is connected via the 10 amp connections to the output. And when I switch on the power supply, I have here totally 5 plus 5 is 10 amps. And we can here read also 10 amps. Not perfect. Ah, now it's perfect. Yes. These instruments are not absolutely true. I've checked it with a precise digital multimeter, there's a small error, but it's sufficient exact for this purpose here, and you can see exactly 10 amps full scale, what we expect. And that's the end of this video. I just want to show you the result. This multimeter now is also optically acceptable. I painted it black here on this side. You remember there was some resin damage here. I used the black paint from a spray can. Fixed the glass new, cleaned it of course. Now it looks very good. On the side here we have the decolorization caused by the age. Here also it's inside, and I don't want to sand it, use sandpaper also or any aggressive solvent. This is not my way to do it. Here is a battery compartment. I added some rubber. I show it. It's a new battery, 1.5 volt. Here's a 9 volt battery. It's a little bit loose, but I added here some rubber, which is used to make windows tight. It's very flexible. Oops. And it squeezes the batteries in place. Well, that's it. That's the result. And now definitely this is the last sequence about the repair of this multimeter, and maybe in one of the next videos we can see it in full action. Stay tuned, stay healthy, and see you on this channel.